Since 1990, we have spent millions of euros and tens of thousands of research hours to find scientific answers to life's most important and challenging questions. What makes us happy? What makes us healthy? How can we heal from physical and mental disease? How can we heal emotionally and sexually so we can be happy in our relationships? How can we develop our talents and be of value to the world? We have interviewed more than 15,000 people and asked more than 4,000 different questions. After 20 years of intensive research, we are beginning to find the answers we have been looking for so long. We have already presented these answers in 250 research papers and about 30 books. Now, bring it all to you. Use and limitations of the biomedical paradigm. This is the title of a paper we wrote some years ago, and it's still an important paper, I think. In this paper, we are discussing when to use drugs and when to use alternative medicine. And the rule is that whenever there is a clear explanation, a clear understanding of the drug's effect on something specific, then it's a good idea to use a drug. For instance, if you have been bitten by a tick and you have erythema migrans, this red spot that grows and shows you that you have the Borrelia bacteria in the body, Lyme's disease, then it's very good to take penicillin, which simply kills this bug. There's a very clear cause of the disease. The infection with the borreliosis, the Borrelia bacteria after the tick bite, and there's a very good reason for this treatment because penicillin kills the bug. So, and that goes for a lot of infection diseases, for instance syphilis, gonorrhea, etc. So, in this case, it's good to use an antibiotics, and you can say the same about energetics, painkillers. If you have a cancer, if you're dying, then morphine is an excellent drug. You will most likely die faster if you use a lot of morphine. But you'll die anyway, and you'll die like a sweet death, a pain-free death. So it's a good idea to allow the cancer patients to self-administer the painkillers, the morphine, and they can take as much as they need and want. Very often doctors are way too restricted with this drug, as I see it. A lot of modern drugs, diuretics, hydrocortisone, antihistamines, anticoagulants, and all these drugs also have their mission. But if it's a chronic disease, and disease without a clear cause, depression, schizophrenia, anxiety, all these psychiatric disorders, or if it's chronic pain, chronic infections that come back and in spite of being treated again and again, then obviously it's not a good idea to use these drugs or to continue using them. So everything that can be like fixed in one go with a good explanation, here drugs are extremely valuable. They're the perfect treatment. How many of the diseases can we treat with drugs then? Maybe 1%. So in general, drugs are not a useful tool in the clinic. In our research clinic in Copenhagen, we are using drugs to about 1% of the patients, like penicillin, and I don't think our results are worse than in the clinic where they only use drugs or use more drugs.